thanks for joining us for this ISE 2024 panel. This one's entitled Sustainability, Does the AV Industry Really Care? Remmelt, first to you, I kind of handpicked you to be here because I know when I've interviewed you before talking about CTOUCH, it's a really central part of your organisation. I just wanted to talk about the wider industry. Do you think enough has been done? Do you think there are companies that really don't put it anywhere near the top of the agenda?
That's a lot of questions to start with, Paul. let me focus on the first question, because we can speak for ourselves, and I think for us, going for sustainability in a broader perspective, so not only product-wise, but more organization-wide, is of a great value. And I think the changing vibe, not only in our market, but I would say on a global scale in society, is going for a more inclusive kind of society. And I think a reflection of this is done by ourselves in creating more value, and that's value product-wise, customer-wise, but I think moreover employee-wise. So how do you deal with the people in your organization? How do you deal with supply chain? And I think we're making terrific steps over there. And a short answer to one of your other questions, I think comes very much to how's the industry behaving on it. Yeah. And I think industry, AV industry still has to make, it's a giant leap for them, almost you could say. But it's a process that you can take step by step.
Sure. Well, I think later on we'll get into what you're doing individually as companies. But I think, Simon, maybe just looking at the wider industry, do you feel disappointed, frustrated, maybe that people aren't doing more? Or walking around here this morning, have you seen companies that are striving to make an effort?
I think it's a two-way street, and I think we need to be leading as an industry. You know, and certainly if we're not leading on it, then our clients need to be pushing us as well. And I think they're now getting into a stage where they've signed up to net zero targets, ESG targets, and they're working out right now how they're going to achieve them, and we make up a big part of that ecosystem, and the footprint of AV around a real estate is huge. So it's really us coming together with our company or our clients, understanding what their ESG goals are, and then working together. And we're both new to this, right? Yeah. Although sustainability has been around a long time, it's now actually got to be actionable and it's now tangible, and we need to start seeing how we're actually going to do those results.
Sure. Luke, do you think the industry's done a good job or bad job so far on sustainability?
I think it's a mixed job.
Yeah.
Quite a lot of companies that are, if you look at, for instance, the suppliers, look around. Last year it was a little bit more that the companies were advertising with, look at us, we're doing some green stuff. Sometimes felt a little bit like greenwashing. But now you see some suppliers that are really doing a good job from a supplier point of view. But if you look at it from an integrator point of view, I think there are a lot of steps to be made. And of course, within integration, the integrators tend to point the finger at the manufacturer. You guys have to do it. You have to go with the better products. But they forget to look at themselves. And I think that makes first impression a little bit different from a lot of other AV integrators, because we really believe in creating a better world. And that's why we also are really proud that we applied for B Corp. And I think with an application like that, you not only show that you're compliant to the needs of the market, but maybe more important, to the needs of our children in the future. And I think, it's again, it's the mixed effort from different ones.
Simon, Luke talked about a mixed effort there. Do you get that from manufacturers? Are some who are great at providing info and others that are maybe not so great?
Absolutely. I know we're going to get into what we do as a company, but I think everybody has to take it from that procurement level as well. And sustainability is the whole value chain. And all of us in the AV industry need to make sure we only use manufacturers that are sustainable and have the right methodologies, that are signed up to B Corp, that are doing this. And that's the only way that we're going to drive the industry forward.
Sure.
By pushing it.
Remmelt, I wanted to ask you, what do you think the barriers are to more companies not embracing sustainability? Is it kind of financial? Is it a kind of cultural thing? What do you think that's stopping them maybe or causing them to be slower than maybe they should be?
I think to a large extent it's a cultural thing, and it's not in their operational business. So therefore, I think it's good for you as a company that you try to put the sustainability in a broader perspective, but put it more like in your vision and in the company's culture. Yeah. And just to give like a small example, the route that we went through in the last 5 years is use green ambassadors, both inside our company, but also outside, so that we have like people that on knowledge basis, we can have a chat with and try to improve doing this step by step. So it means it needs to go throughout the whole supply chain. You cannot do it just by yourselves. And I think, as Simon was pointing out, I think for an industry as such, it's also important that you comply to net zero or near zero targets, and preferably also try to fill in your scope 1, 2, 3. And it sounds all very technical, but in the end, it's just like a matter of trying, making small steps and doing the first things that are pretty simple and everybody can do it.
Sure. Where do you, Luke, this one's to you maybe, where do you think the drive will actually eventually come from? Do you think it will be from the sort of client end, you know, like Levi's or Pepsi will have their own targets and then they'll say to you, as our chosen integrator, you need to provide, will it come from them, do you think?
Yeah, I'd love to that you ask this question, but I want to add this to the conversation because yes, from client side, it is becoming much more important. And not only we as an industry trying to make steps, but our clients are too. And sometimes go even further than we as an industry, as a company. They have to report on it too. So if you look at RFPs that are going out right now in the market, sustainability is becoming a bigger part in every RFP that is coming in. So you either can sit down and say this one is going to pass, I think you're going to be out of business in the future if you're not going to act now, because it's not a one-day process. It is a process that will take time and keeps taking your time, because you have to be compliant every step in the way, not only in one day, not now, not only for your application, but in the future with every step you make.
Simon, are you seeing it on more tenders that Is it moving up the kind of criteria
Absolutely.
List?
Absolutely, you know, we're seeing anything percentage-wise in terms of weighting, you know, especially in public sector, anything from 20 to 30% on ESG, well, CSR.
It's also from retailer side, so yeah. it not only from the public side.
What's really interesting there is these are not just, I mean, ESG goes social as well, so that's where we're now seeing that, especially in organisations, HR are taking a lead. And in IT, you're making sure the right technology gets deployed. So it's the coming together of HR, the coming together of IT. You know, they make the decisions and then they put in what technology should be involved from there. So it's a whole new landscape in terms of how leadership's getting run from those companies.
Remmelt, are you seeing more requests from system integrators and AV consultants for that kind of information that your products have on them?
I think it's about to start. We just like it at the beginning of it, I think. But to add to the previous question, what we see changing in UK, for instance, DfE driving more the business towards sustainability and their like ambitions going to net zero become more obvious in tenders that will be published. And the same actually is changing as per 2024 in Germany, whereas German law tells you that you need to comply to certain sustainability standards. And the points that are given in those German tenders are taken off by the points that normally come to pricing as a qualification criteria. So you see it more balancing out at this moment.
So you wonder if you all see it as a kind of a gradual process, and if we have this conversation this time next year, something will have changed, but it won't be kind of seismic. Do you think it'll, Luke, do you think it'll be gradual change year by year?
I don't think, gradually. I don't think it will be a major increase in what we're going to see in the markets. I think the requirements from all our clients in the market will be bigger and bigger and bigger. So we have to comply as an industry if you want to compete for business in the future. So No, not a dramatic increase. I don't expect that. Maybe more factors involved. It's sustainability, but we see also parts coming in and RFPs about equality, and those kinds of principles. And I don't think that's going to rule the show in the future, but it's going to be a part of the show.
So I mean, you see a gradual increase.
It's a gradual increase that's backed up by whatever country you're in and the local. I think you mentioned it. The EU are obviously very forward thinking when it comes to regulation and what the companies have to comply to, and then we fit into that. And that's very different to the way the US would act and its different regulations. So yes, it's going to be gradual, and it's also going to be local gradual as well.
You have to be adaptive because it's not only country-wise that the regulations might change. Sometimes it's even city-wise that regulations are different. So within a project, you really have to scope and zoom in on different locations with local regulations.
That's a lot of work for integrators.
It is.
But I think since the Green Act passed on, and we have like Paris and obviously the last session for COP28, I think things are changing quicker and quicker. So I think the gradual change, and that we didn't put enough effort to it as an industry, that time has passed. So I think there is no return. So you need to move forward. And I think the best driver in the heart, in the end, is do it by the heart. But if it doesn't work by the heart, then it's more like the harder way by law. Yeah. And I think the by law thing is now getting really put into place. And you better comply, because if not, I think not going green will put you out of business.
Yeah.
And that's not next year, perhaps not in 26, but I'm for sure that if you look at a 3-5 years perspective, it's like a no-brainer, at least for Europe.
Yeah, sure. And finally, I wanted to touch on kind of what your country's companies are doing kind of individually to this. Let's start with you, because I know every time I've interviewed you, I've been impressed at how sustainability has been a central tenet for CTOUCH for a long time, and way before kind of nearly every company I've ever spoken to, really. Yeah. What is it that you could kind of tell the people watching that you prioritise in terms of sustainability?
I think we see this as a need to do, as Simon previously mentioned, because it's like good for our children and the next generation. Yeah. So I think to society, it's something it's a way we need to go. And on the other side, I think it also comes from the heart. So it's something you really should believe in. So I would say I'm like a pioneer believer to going green. And third of all, I'm like convinced, and this is like to the offense of the deep green people, but I think it can be a driver of your business as well. So it doesn't need that your business will be harmed by going green. And it's just like about investments and extra costs, because I don't think so. It's about reinventing the industry. And I believe in taking the lead, you go through a learning curve, you learn from first impression, you learn from Kinley, and together we can make those steps.
What are some of the things that CTOUCH does, really, in terms of, is it the materials that you look at carefully, or the processing, or the manufacturing, or?
As a product company, as a manufacturer, we started from product side, but we gradually moved to ESG, so a more broad and society perspective to it as well, because those need to balance out as well. But at the heart of the company, as being a tech company, we are very focused on the product. So that's very much to creating LCAs for your product, making a modular design for the products, taking care for updates in the future, taking care of end of life and lifetime improvement, and also taking back responsibility of the product. And I think that's something that could be really good for AV industry. If you pollute the industry by sending millions of screens into the marketplace, please take them back as well, and take care after life for those screens as well, because you've put them into the marketplace. Our kids didn't ask for this, and the neighbor didn't ask for it either. So please take it back.
Sure, fantastic. Simon, what are Kinley doing with regards to sustainability?
So, we made a big strategic alignment to sustainability at the end of last year. So we've just hired a new global head of sustainability. And that person, one, she's going to help us do our internal sustainability values to make sure Kinley can at the right accreditation, the right certification point, but it's also externally to make sure that we're aligning to the right values there. But what we're really looking at doing is building out our sustainability by design framework. So, and that would be us looking at the whole of the value chain, looking at everything from procurement, installation, life cycle of endpoints, the ideas to the framework that Kinley set, that everything along that value chain would be sustainable. So we're going to make sure the manufacturers that we align to are only manufacturers that adhere to the policies that we demand for sustainability. And if they don't, then unfortunately, you know, we were not going to be choosing them to deal with them. So we are really taking it really seriously this year. And that will hopefully then, you know, go into our clients so we can start having those discussions with our clients. And we no longer just want to talk to IT. The first thing we want to do is talk to the ESG team. If we can talk to the ESG team, understand what their values are, understand what their targets are, then the roll down of technology is quite easy. And that's beyond just making sure you're buying the right products and putting sustainable solutions in. It's also monitoring those products, understanding, optimizing those products year on year or month or quarter on quarter, that we're using those products efficiently. You know, we're reducing, having a carbon plan reduction across the whole life cycle. So yeah, we're new to this. Everyone's new to this. We're not experts, you know, but you know, it's a learning process. We're not experts. That's why we hired an expert.
So, do you think, just one more question before I come to you, Luke, do you think more AV companies will hire a specific sustainability
role? I think everybody has to. Yeah. I mean, you mentioned, you know, that's a lot of work, your comment for an integrator, and it's a lot of work. So we need to hire a specialist to be able to look out for this. And I think you mentioned that, you know, if you don't, AV companies will struggle and they won't be around in 5 years' time. That's a serious comment. You know, if we don't start taking sustainability seriously, the ones who do will stay, the ones who don't will go.
Yeah, but I think you shouldn't approach it as hiring in a specialist as like outsourcing some of the work.
Okay.
Because in the end, as a company, you need to embrace and also get knowledge around the domain of sustainability. It's a company-wide thing, and you cannot just do it like as a side business.
No, it's got to be a strategic.
And global, Luke, finally to you, what how do first impression deal with the kind of sustainability issues? What are you doing?
Quite a lot, actually, and we've been doing this for a few years already. And as I said, it's easy to only look at your suppliers, but we start looking into our own organization. What can we do in the total process of AV integration that will benefit? And we started off by looking at installations in general. How can you make installations worldwide more efficient, but with a footprint that is a lot less? Travel movement is a big part of the footprint we make as integrators that work all over the globe. So we invented a new way of deploying devices that's called smart deployment. That is a way of working where we have a pre-production that we do in our own facilities, send only out one package to the other side of the world. It's all being guided by an app that leads you step by step through the total process. And in that way, we don't need to send out teams all over the world. We only need one and sometimes none, so we can have the installation done by a shop fitter. It's not only cheaper, but it's also a footprint that is a lot less. And on the other hand, a big part is also in doing service on location. So that's why we started off in building our own network operating center already a few years ago, where we connect every device that we deploy and actually can see every device that we deploy, not only a media player, but also screens, controllers, etc. Not only if they're on or off, but literally every spec that we need to know. And by doing so, we can do proactive monitoring, even preventing that a problem will occur. But also, roughly 80% of all the problems that will occur, we can manage and fix them from a distance, from our headquarters. So the time that we have to go to a location, driving, carbon footprint, is reduced by a tremendous amount. And those are just two examples, just to show that you also can look at your own organization and do things and make innovations that will benefit the better world.
I think the innovation part is a very interesting one, Luke, because if it drives also like going more after services in AV industry. it's thinking clever about what you're offering to your customer, I think, and then services can really add and contribute to that. So I think that's an innovation driving sustainability as well. And secondly, as Simon mentioned, it's you create a different relationship in throughout the channel. So it's both to vendor, manufacturer, but also to your customer, because you're dialoguing in a different way. It's not only the dialogue around the product, but it's more the dialogue on how do you contribute as a company to society and what common drivers do we have.
But it's also, there's also a difficulty here, because innovation is money. So where do I invest my money as a company? And I don't have the books of every other AV integrator, but I can imagine that it's sometimes difficult to allocate a certain budget. And those budgets can be really high if you want to do it properly, and maybe not do that to a different part in your company that might need it also to run your business. So, and that's of course, the difficult two-way street, where which one to enter. And in the end, you still have to run a business. And yes, I also believe that the green approach will be really important for the future. But nobody can do green in the future if you don't have your company anymore. Sure. And we need everybody in.
Sure. That's great. It's great to hear all three companies are kind of are taking action, and I hope more of this kind of the show will be doing the same. And all that's left for me to do is thank you very much, gentlemen, for taking part. And thanks for joining us today. And there's plenty more panel discussions coming up from ISE 2024. Bye-bye.